1857, the Great Revolt. Okay, and this is also called as the first war of independence. Okay, this is the first war which was fought for the freedom or independence of India. Why? Because before this 1857, so many kings fought against the Britishers. But why they fought against the Britishers? Just to save their kingdom. Okay, to save their kingdoms. But here, for the first time in our Indian history, in the year 1857, all together fought against the Britishers to send them away from our country and to get the freedom. Okay, now, so first of all, we have to discuss about the main causes of 1857 revolt. Okay, what were the causes? The main causes of the revolt 1857 are classified into mainly 5 types. One is political cause, second one economic cause, third one military cause, fourth one social cause, and fifth one immediate cause. Okay, all these are the causes for the revolt of 1857. Now let us discuss individually. So first of all, political cause. Okay, political cause means related to administration. Okay, see here, involving in our political matters. The British East India Company, this company made so many treaties with our Indian kingdoms, and according to those treaties, they involved in our internal political matters. Okay, next, policies like annexation, subsidiary alliance. Okay, from trade to territory chapter we have discussed policy of annexation. That means annexation means occupying. How the Britishers occupied our Indian kingdoms by their policies. Example, doctrine of lapse. If any king doesn't have son, then his kingdom will be occupied by the Britishers. Okay, that is one thing. Next, subsidiary alliance system. Our local Indian kings should provide shelter to the British army, and our local kings should maintain the expenditures of the British army, everything. Okay, all these policies were made by the Britishers in our India. By those policies, our Indian people suffered a lot. Example, so many kingdoms lost their independence and they were occupied by the Britishers because of this policy of annexation. Okay, example, Jhansi, Satara. Okay, all those places were occupied by the Britishers. By which policy? By the policy of annexation. Okay, and by the policy of a subsidiary system, subsidiary alliance system, our kings lost economically. That means the economical burden increased on our local kings, and our local king's army reduced and the British army increased. Okay, and next thing, kings lost their powers, rights, titles. Okay, because of East India Company's rule in our India, our kings lost their powers and our kings lost their rights, whatever they had, and our kings lost their titles also. Okay, so all these things were lost by our Indian kings because of Britishers. Okay, so all these are the reasons for the political cause. That means 1857 revolt. Because of all these things, our Indian kings became angry. So they wanted to take revenge on the Britishers. That's where they are ready to fight against the British. They are waiting for a situation. Okay? In 1857, that situation came. Next, after the political cause, economic causes. Okay? Economic means related to money. Economic means what? Related to money. Now see here. Collection of high taxes regularly and even during famines. Actually, the Britishers collected so much taxes from our Indians. Okay? Every year they collected so much taxes. And even during the famines also. Famines means a situation in which people suffered with lack of food. The people will suffer with lack of food. That kind of situation is called as famine. For example, during floods. Floods. Whenever the floods comes, then total agriculture fields and everything will be damaged. Then the people will not get food materials for the eating purpose. Okay? And during the drought time, drought. Drought means very very scanty, less rainfall or without rainfall. Okay? Then in that situation what happens? We can't grow the crops and we can't get food grains. So, in both the situations like floods and droughts, the Britishers had collected high amount of taxes from the people. Okay? So that's why all the people were very angry on the Britishers. Here you can see one figure. See here, in this picture, you can see some people. How their condition? And these people belong to West Bengal. That means at that time Bengal area. In Bengal, famines came. Okay? So at that time, the people suffered with lack of food. So in this situation also, the British tried to collect high amount of taxes from the people. Okay? That's why all the people felt very angry on the Britishers. And here you can see one picture. So this is the handloom industry had been destroyed. In our India, handloom industries were there. Okay? From cotton, our people made some cloths. But here after the arrival of Britishers, what happened? They exported our cotton to the England. In the England, they manufactured the cloths and they brought to India. In India, they sold those cloths. That's why our Indian industries, especially handloom industries, had been destroyed. They got so much loss and they were closed because of Britishers. That's why all the weavers, workers, they got angry on the Britishers. So here also everybody is trying to take revenge on the Britishers. Next, one more cause, religious cause, related to religion. In our India, most of the people are Hindus and Muslims. Okay? But the British people, Christians. See here, what happened? Christian missionaries. So, through the British East India Company, some Christian missionaries came to India to expand their Christianity. Okay, now? To expand the Christianity in our India, some Christian missionaries came. Okay, now? Christian missionaries. That means a group of people. A group of Christian people. Okay? Here you can see. All these are Hindus. Okay? And here, Christian. So, the Christians are trying to convert all these Hindus into their religion. Okay? And here, if anybody is not accepting to join in their religion, then sometimes they punish also. Okay? That means forcefully they try to convert all the Hindus and Muslims into the Christianity. That's why all Hindus and Christians, they got angry. Okay, now? They felt that their tradition, their religion is getting spoiled, getting destroyed. That's why they want to stop these Christian missionaries. and they want to fight against the Britishers. Just they are waiting for a situation. Okay. Next. One more thing here. Taxes on religious pilgrimage. Religious pilgrimage means, pilgrimage means traveling to holy places. Traveling to holy places. So the Britishers had collected some tax on these religious pilgrimage also. For example, I am one of the Hindu. This year I want to go to Kashi or any one holy place. Then the Britishers are collecting some tax from me for this religious travel. Okay now. So then how I feel? I feel very angry on the Britishers. That's in the same way so many Indians, that means Hindus or Muslims, they got angry on the Britishers. Why? Because the Britishers are collecting so much tax on the pilgrimage also. Okay na? So because of these reasons also, the Indians wanted to fight against the Britishers. Next, one more reason, social cause. Social in the sense, society means people. Okay, here the Britishers show some racial discrimination against the Indians. Discrimination means partiality. Here racial means, see here, in our India all the people almost black in color, okay, and the Britishers white in color. That means they have separated the people into two groups. One is the black race and the one is the white race. Black people, white people. And they have shown so much partiality in between them. Okay, now, so much differentiation in between white and black. See here, racial discrimination. You can see in this figure, the Britishers, they are torturing some black people, that means Indians. Okay? And in administration also, the higher posts were given for the Britishers only. In our India, they started their administration. Okay now? To rule different areas, the Britishers need some employees. So for that employment purpose, they employed Britishers only in the higher posts. And some lower posts were given for the Indians. That means some partiality. They are showing some discrimination also they are showing. And one more thing, involving and elimination of some social custom. The Britishers are involving in our social customs. And the Britishers also eliminated some of our social customs. Here social customs means, I will show you. Our Indians followed one system, that is sati or sati pratha. Okay, whenever the husband dies, then the wife also should be burned in this flame. Okay, that is sati. But here the Britishers interfered in this social customs and the Britishers banned this sati. That means ban on sati system. The Britishers imposed ban on sati system. And one more thing, in our India, whenever the husband dies, okay na, the lady becomes a widow and she should not get marriage again. But the Britishers encouraged widow remarriages. Okay, the Britishers encouraged widow remarriages. That means they are involving, they are means the Britishers involving in our social customs. Then our people felt that our social customs were destroyed or spoiled by the Britishers. Then to protect our culture, to protect our customs, our people wanted to fight against the Britishers. Okay? Sati Mata ki jai, 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 Sati Mata ki jai.
में मत पड़िए, ये हमारे धर्म का मामला है।
लेकिन सती आप कानून के खिलाफ है।
किसी भी बाखुशी जो चलाना जुर्म है।
कप्तान साहब आप दखल मत दीजिए, ये हमारी परंपरा है।
मेरी भी परंपरा है, किसी का खून होते नहीं देख सकता।
इस औरत को वापिस कर दीजिए साहब, वरना अच्छा नहीं होगा।
पहले मुंह से मारो, फिर ले जाओ।
नेक्स्ट वन मोर रीजन, मिलिटरी कास्ट। ओके, मिलिटरी कास्ट। हियर इन द मिलिटरी इनइक्वालिटी इन पे, पे मींस इन गिविंग सैलरीज। ओके, दैट मींस फॉर द ब्रिटिश सोल्जर्स द सैलरीज आर हाई, एंड फॉर द इंडियन सोल्जर्स सैलरीज आर वेरी लेस। ओके, दैट मींस इनइक्वालिटी इन द सैलरीज। नेक्स्ट, लो लेवल पोस्ट फॉर इंडियंस। इन द आर्मी the high grade posts were given for the Britishers and low level posts were given for the Indian soldiers. And one more thing, stricter rules on religious look of Indian soldiers. Here the Britishers implemented some strict rules on the Indian soldiers. Those rules are, our Indian soldiers should change the traditional look. What is the traditional look of Indian soldiers? You can see here some pagdis. Okay, next beard and some tilak. Okay, now this is a tradition, this is a traditional look of Indian soldiers. The Britishers ordered these Indian soldiers to change their traditional look. Okay, so that's why all soldiers became very angry. They do not want to follow the Britishers rule orders. That's why they are eagerly waiting for a chance to fight against the Britishers. Finally, one chance came. That is, see here, immediate cause. Immediate cause means 1857 revolt started with this main reason. Okay, na? See here. Observe the figure carefully. So this one. This is one cartridge. Okay, cartridge. In this cartridge, some powder will be there. Okay, and one bullet will be present here. And this will be sealed. Okay, na? That will be sealed or covered by paper case. Okay, na? And here, in order to seal this cartridge, the Britishers used the fat of cows and pigs. Okay, the Britishers used the fat of cow and pig in order to seal this cartridge. And see here, how to use this cartridge. And this is Enfield rifle. The Britishers introduced in our India Enfield rifles, long gun. How to use this cartridge in this Enfield rifle? See here. So we have to bite this cartridge paper case, and then we have to pour the powder into this Enfield rifle, and we have to push that bullet and powder inside. Okay, then we can use that Enfield rifle. So here the main thing is, our Indian soldiers also should bite this cartridge with their teeth. Okay, now that means here indirectly they are taking the fat of cows and pigs, but actually the Hindus, for the Hindus, cow is a sacred animal. Okay, now we are worshipping, the Hindus are worshipping cow. That's why they don't want to put the cartridge which is sealed with the fat of cow. Okay, and for the Muslims, pig meat was forbidden by Quran. In the Quran they mentioned that no Muslim should use the fat of pig and the meat of pig also. That's why our Indian soldiers, especially Hindus and Muslims, They refused to use this cartridges. Okay?
ना EFL राइफल दुनिया की सबसे अच्छी राइफल है। Enfield और तुम्हारी पुरानी ब्राउन बेस्ट मस्किट में ज्यादा फर्क नहीं, बड़की या हड़की है और हजार कस तक निशाना लगाती है। पुरानी बंदूक से पांच गुना से ज्यादा और ये है कारतूस, इसमें बारूद भी है और गोली भी। Billy Katusko, that's a Kato. Fear Barut and the Dalo. Fear your goalie Tuso. On Escobar, Zor, Say, Toko. On fire, Kano.
चलो तुम ट्राई करो, तुम और तुम। कम ऑन चारी चारी, कम ऑन आगे आओ।
सी इज मंगल पांडे, वन ऑफ द इंडियन सोल्जर हु इज वर्किंग इन ब्रिटिश आर्मी एंड ही बिकेम अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स एंड ही किल्ड, दैट मींस ही अटैक्ड वन ऑफ द ब्रिटिश। Okay, here on 29th March 1857, Mangal Pandey revolted in Barakpur. Barakpur means this is one of the cantonments of the Britishers. And in this Barakpur, that means cantonment, Mangal Pandey revolted against the Britishers on 29th March 1857. And he killed the British officers also. Okay, no? He killed the British officers also. And because of this reason, he was hanged by the Britishers on 8th April 1857. Okay, na? Hanged by the Britishers on 8th April 1857. That means after this incident, all the soldiers of different cantonments of India, they start decided compulsory we have to fight with the Britishers, we have to defeat the Britishers and we have to eliminate them. So in this way, the 1857 revolt was started, and it was led by so many different leaders of India. Okay. And Mangala, 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 Ho. Mangala, 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 Ho.